this hour in connection with tonight's brutal murders, the bloody hot family and was described by police as Manson-like in its viciousness and more horrific than any movie Hollywood could imagine. Judith Meyer's nude body was found lying face down in a pool of blood in an upstairs hallway. Apparently, she had been stabbed 17 times. Her boyfriend Stephen Haley's body was found in the kitchen downstairs, the victim of an apparent vicious beating with an aluminum baseball bat. Along with Myers and Haley, a third victim, Ronnie White, was found bound to a chair, White's neck slit wide open with a kitchen knife, and stabbed numerous times in the face and chest. Of course, we'll have much more on this horrific story as it develops, but for now, three people brutally murdered and a 10-year-old boy, Michael Myers, being held in custody.
I'm standing outside Smith's Grove Sanitarium, where late last night, 10-year-old Michael Myers was transferred after being found guilty of first-degree murder. Myers' verdict comes after one of the lengthiest and most expensive trials in the state's history. In attendance during this trial, Dr. Samuel Loomis. Loomis has now been appointed by Judge Masterson to oversee Myers' care while incarcerated here at Smith's Grove.
Michael has begun to obsess on the construction of these primitive masks. It is the rare occasion that he will allow himself to be seen without one of these. Only during the weekly visits from his mother does he show brief glimpses of the boy he once may have been. Michael's so-called normal moments are becoming fewer and fewer, and I'm particularly worried about this. I believe it's these masks have begun to create a mental sanctuary in which Michael can hide within himself and from himself.
Fuck you! Fuck your world! I hate you! Shut the fuck up! I'm gonna get out of here! Just let me out!
I don't want to be here anymore. I just want to go home.
It's okay.